Welcome back, everyone. My name's TRP Strife, and this is Subnautica. Our tree grew. It actually worked. We have a full-blown tree in our base. I also had to modify the base a little bit. We needed some more storage room. And I need some more coffee. I did not sleep well last night. Did I get my coffee? I got my coffee. There we go. But we got everything we need to go out back to the island and teleport ourselves to that other island and see what's going on. There's something in front of me, isn't there? Nope. Why is it so. Oh, another eclipse. Jeez, these are always so terrifying. Okay, here we are back at the teleporter. I still think I have everything I need. Let's go check out this other. Ooh, this other island. Wow, that burns to redness. Wow. All right. At some point, I need to go back into the quarantine enforcement platform or whatever they call the gun base and check out that teleporter again. See if it's working. We do have the laser cutter as well. We need to go out and check those wrecks out. This is really cool. We got varying types of plant life, if nothing else. Is that any good? Pink leafy plant. Doesn't seem to be for anything. Maybe I can get something from it. A bunch of seeds. Alright. I don't want to tank up too much on some of this stuff. Jaffa cup. Common land fungus, commonly found in clusters, grows quickly. But is it useful? Well, there went a bunch of my inventory space already. Well, the path goes two ways. Let's go this way. What is that? That looks like a thing. Screw roads. Okay, first, Ming plant. It doesn't do anything. Besides, take up a ridiculous amount of inventory space. Why? What are you? Exterior grow bed. That answers that question before I can ask it. Marble melon? Edible, high water content. I love you already. I can pick it. And I can chop it. Okay, so chopping it gives me seeds. Numb. That is great. I am happy. But this grow bed, can I actually do something with that? Artificial plant bed suitable for use on land or underwater. Can I grow plants outside my base? I hadn't even considered. What is this? Okay, can't chop ya. Chinese potato plant. I can grow food. I think. Edible sores. Chinese potato plants, blah 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 blah. Oh wow. Really good food. There went my entire inventory already. Wasn't expecting to be quite so bountiful here. Food. Like, that takes care of everything, pretty much. What's that? Oh, hey, there's another. Is that a lagoon? Oh, jeez, don't walk off the ledge. I don't want to find out if there's fall damage that badly. We're just gonna keep going up. I want to see what these two. They look like buildings. Like, habitats that I would build. But they look really discolored. Maybe that's just the way they look if you build on land? No, I don't think that's the case. That looks like it's been here a while. Can I just. Wow, I can run right up the sides of mountains. I am. Spotlight. That's awesome. Bulkhead. That sounds useful. Observatory. So these are new things I can build at the base, I think. Structural support, spotlights. Huh. Nope. Oh, don't fall off the. Okay, before we go inside. Might take a while to walk all over this island and see everything there is to see. I really do feel all alone out here. Scanner room? I don't know what a scanner room is, but I'll take it. Water. No, leave that open so I know I got. Bart Togel's log number 3. Indoor grow bed. Well, this could be very useful. A fern plant. Grub basket. Oh my, how did I not really notice you? You are. Why are you. I see why you're called what you're called. You are really cool. But you glow in the dark nicely. Okay, anything here I can just grab. Great. Is that useful? Well, I have full inventory now. It's food. Maybe I can plant that. Alright, inventory is pretty much maxed out. Gonna run back, drop our stuff off, and come right back here and figure out what's going on. Actually, first, I'm gonna read this PDA. Okay, yeah. One of the missions of the Aurora was to search for these, it was the CEO of the competition of Altera. Or at least I think that's where it was. Anyway, let's see, what's it say? Bart Togel's log number 3, what's left? I messed up badly this time. It's been 2 days since what happened. We never should have left the island. We never should have left this island. I shouldn't have listened to them. We shouldn't have gone so deep. We're not wanted down there. They don't trust us. I knew it and I didn't say. I couldn't see. I could see it, and they couldn't. And now they're stuck down there, and I'm up here, all alone. I deserve this. I have no idea what he's talking about. Who? Okay, yeah. So there was Paul Torgel, Margaret, and Bart. Now we found Bart's PDA, so this must be Bart's base. I can build my base above water? I never even considered that as a possibility. Okay. Is there anything else I can get? That does nothing. That does nothing. I don't think I have one of these yet. There we go. Picked up some more stuff, and that takes up a lot of inventory space. Frickin' seeds are huge on this planet. How long has this place been here? That's right, the PDA said that Degassi had been missing for like 10 years, so. Wow, they probably. Well. This has long since been abandoned. And that one doesn't look like it's in any better shape. Oh, there's a third one down there. Multi-purpose. I don't know what I'm scanning. This sounds important. You want some? I stabby stab. I will. I'll do it. Ooh, that's. Oh, you. So, yeah, multi-purpose room. This big thing. Which might be useful, because I tried to make a vending machine and I noticed it's too big for the corridor I've been using. Another purple artifact that's going to be useful, I'm sure. Sucks to be you. Degassi voice log number two, the storm. Bart, I said no. Your life is worth more than your vegetable patch. I forbid you to go out there in the storm. I stopped needing your permission when the ship you were captaining sunk. You will stop needing my permission the day I'm not your father. Say, Chief. Chief. What? Do you know how to drain those grow beds out there of 40 tons of storm water? Or how to conjure food from the air? Don't try to be clever. No one likes a clever mercenary. I'm just saying, what's your boy's life worth to you today if next week you're gonna be so hungry you start wondering what he tastes like? Let him go deal with the plants. Son, go deal with the plants. Bart Torkoal is no longer aboard the habitat. Interfere with my family again, and when rescue arrives, I will leave you here. You understand me? No rescue coming, Chief. Not in time. And no staying here, neither. The rain keeps falling, and sooner or later this place will be buried. Only choice we've got is whether we get buried with it. Stay away from my boy. Well, I'd say Margaret was right. It looks like this place got buried. I'm gonna have me a melon. What's a living wall? Oh! Decoration piece. I probably just can't see it because I scanned it from the outside. How do I get in? Here we go. Are you trying to tell me I'm gonna get beat up? You're probably right. Come here, I'm not done. One more. There we go. Wait, you're still. You're not twitching now, are you? Battery. Paul Torgo's log number one. I'll check that out in just a moment. So that's the living wall, huh? That's cool. That's very cool. Is there anything else in here? Paul Torgo's log number one, marooned. Captain's logs, 5 weeks since our ship, the Degassi, was shot down. I give thanks that fate saw fit to spare my son. Bart and I from death, but my personal entourage were not so destined. The only other survivor was Margaret Maida, a cut-price mercenary with local expertise who I reluctantly commissioned for the journey. We spent days in the life pods, rain beating on the roof, nothing but the ocean on the horizon. Just as we were losing hope, the weather cleared and we saw this island, this floating oasis. We were saved. Floating. We salvaged the Gossy wreck down to its bare bones and built this habitat from the scrap. I set Bart to studying the alien plant life and arranging us a stable source of food. Put that expensive digit training to good use. People can question digit training and foreign technology all they like. Bart's biochem imprint already paid for itself. As I dictate this, I'm eating hydroponically grown potato salad garnished with seeds that taste like spicy orange peel. Our only problem is Maida. I've caught her muttering that the island is too small to support us indefinitely, that the weather's going to turn on us. I'd say she's growing superstitious. Every judgment she makes assumes things go from bad to worse, that the only forward is a fight. She ought to take some contacts. As a species, we've spent a millennia learning how to shackle nature to our will. This planet won't cause us any new troubles. Our one task now is to stay alive and as comfortable as possible until rescue arrives. In this part of space, that could be months or even years. I don't want to be here for years. Not alone. Come on. That just sounds bad. All right. Why'd you guys leave me here? Oh, the pot. Yay. That's it? Well, I guess it is important to the story, but. The Degassi voice log number one, habitation location. Margaret, it won't do, Chief. There's nothing left on that Degassi, no building materials on this island, and my nose tells me the weather is turning. We're gonna have to get our feet wet. This island is safe. There are no predators. We can grow food. Why would we abandon it? Your kid says we can't grow enough food, not without more grow beds. Speak up, kid. It's true. The natural growth rates are too slow to support three of us indefinitely, especially if the weather gets worse. All I'm saying is, ocean's got us surrounded, no use hiding. I've made my decision. You two want to forfeit your commissions just to take a swim? Believe me, I'm thinking on it. This would probably be a hell of a view if the glass wasn't dirty. It's not a resource haven in the way of, like, materials I'm going to carry back to my base, like lithium on the other island. But yeah. This has very much been worth it for the food, especially if I can grow all this stuff in a base. I wonder if there's anything else on this island. I've already found so much. But it is huge. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if there's something else here. Okay. Just saying. If I was to. I can actually build right here. Boom. How would I get on it, though? I could build this here. But nah. Somebody else tried building on land. It didn't work for them. Although there was three of them, and that seems to have been what the problem was. Hard to believe there's not enough food here for everybody with all of this growing. I mean, not all of it is edible, but I mean, there's a lot of food here. It's a nice little trail. Is there any point to it? There's something glowing. There was a point to it. Gossy voice log number three, aftermath. You see, Chief, you brought us to this sodden planet. You told us we'd see a lush payday. Now what do we got some 6 weeks later? Most of the crew's dead. A pile of dirt in our front room, rain coming in through the windows, food destroyed. I suppose you, with your extensive experience in hitting people in the face, you'd make a much better captain. I know I'd start by not taking unscheduled detours by alien water worlds. That's something you never want to learn the hard way. Let's hear it then. What's your plan? I have a site scouted out. It's a cave a couple of 100 meters down. Lots of lithium deposits, good for building. How do you imagine we'd live? I figured two water filters would keep the three of us going. We could build a bioreactor to cover our power. Chief, we'll eat seaweed salad if that's what it takes, or do you got something better? Send the coordinates to my PDA. I'll review your proposal. Okay. So there's another base below me, huh? Gotta go check that out too. Jeez, it's just one thing after the other. I'm gonna have to make a checklist of all the things that I need to do. There is fall damage. Well, I didn't actually take fall damage. It's actually closer for me to swim to my life pod from here than to go to the other island via teleporter and swim back. It's 800 meters, well, 850 meters versus like 1,000 meters going from the alien gun base. I'm also curious about something. So save. Why did they say floating? It's floating. This whole island is floating. It actually makes me a little nauseous to my stomach thinking about that. Okay, whatever. We're gonna try to just go for it across the surface. I haven't been out this way, I don't know. Oh god, it's deep. Oh, there is land though. There is land. Why wouldn't there be land? This is kind of cool. I think I scouted this out earlier as a potential place to build a house. It's not far from where we're at. But we have made it back. Holy crap, we did it. And we got all sorts of stuff. And we know
Welcome aboard,
that
Captain.
there's another base out there under the floating island somewhere, so at least according to the PDA. We have two or three places we need to go out and use laser cutters. And I need to take inventory stock on what new equipment we can make. We also probably need to look at making a more permanent habitat to live out of. Maybe we can do something with this multi-purpose room. It looks like it's a bigger thing. We'll figure that out. It'll be fun. Anyway, thank you guys for watching the show. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you have, like, subscribe, share, maybe leave me a comment down below, and just stay awesome, and I'll catch you next time. Later.